Talk by Father Jeremy Habayarimana, January 25th, Feast of the Conversion of St. Paul. The conversion of St. Paul is a great joy for the whole church. Get up, get the baptism that, by calling on the name of Jesus, it will be washed away your sins. A reading from the Book of Acts Apostles, 22, verse 3 to 16. Paul addressed the people in these words. I am a Jew, born in Tarsus in Cilicia, but brought up in this city. At the feet of Gamaliel, I was educated strictly in our ancestral law and was zealous for God, just as all of you are today. I persecuted this way to death, binding both men and women and delivering them to prison. Even the high priest and the whole council of elders can testify on my behalf. For from them I even received letters to the brothers and set out for Damascus to bring back to Jerusalem in chains for punishment those there as well. On that journey, as I drew near to Damascus, about noon a great light from the sky suddenly shone around me. I fell to the ground and hear a voice saying to me, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? I replied, Who are you, sir? And he said to me, I am Jesus the Nazarene, whom you are persecuting. My companions saw the light but did not hear the voice of the one who spoke to me. I asked, What should I do, sir? The Lord answered me, Get up and go into Damascus, and there you will be told about everything appointed for you to do. Since I could see nothing because of the brightness of the light, I was led by the hand by my companions and entered Damascus. A certain Ananias, a devout observer of the law, and a highly spoken of by all the Jews who lived there, came to me and stood there and said, Saul, my brother, regain your sight. And at that very moment I regained my sight and saw him. Then he said, The God of our ancestors designed you to know his will, to see the righteous one, and to hear the sound of his voice. For you will be the witness before all to what you have seen and heard. Now why delay you? Get up and have yourself baptized and your sins washed away, calling upon his name. Or they will tell you what to do. A reading from the Book of Acts of the Apostles 9:1-22. Saul, still breathing murderous threats against the disciples of the Lord, went to the highest priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues in Damascus, that if he should find any man or woman who belonged to the way, he might bring them back to Jerusalem in chains. On his journeys, as he was nearing Damascus, a light from the sky suddenly flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? He said, Who are you, sir? The reply came, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. Now get up and go into the city, and you will be told what you must to do. The man who were traveling with him stood speechless, for they heard the voice but couldn't see no one. Saul got up from the ground, but when he opened his eyes, he couldn't see nothing. So they laid him by the hand and brought him to Damascus. For 3 days he was unable to see, and he neither ate nor drank. There was a disciple in Damascus named Ananias. And the Lord said to him in a vision, Ananias. He answered, Here I am, Lord. The Lord said to him, Get up and go to the street called Straight, and ask at the house of Judas for a man from Tarsus named Saul. He is there praying, and in a vision he has seen a man named Ananias come in and lay his hand on him, that he may regain his sight. But Ananias replied, Lord, I have heard from many sources about this man, what evil things he has done to your holy ones in Jerusalem. and here he has authority from the chief priest to imprison all who call upon your name. But the Lord said to him, Go, for this man is a chosen instrument of mine to carry my name before Gentiles, kings, and children of Israel, and I will show him what he will have to suffer for my name. So Ananias went and entered the house. Laying his hands on him, he said, Saul, my brother, the Lord has sent me. Jesus, who appeared to you on the way by which you came, that you may regain your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit. Immediately, things like scales fell from his eyes and he regained his sight. He got up and was baptized, and when he had eaten, he recovered his strength. He stayed some days with the disciples in Damascus, and he began at once to proclaim Jesus in the synagogues that he is the Son of God. All who heard him were astonished and said, It is not this man who in Jerusalem revives those who call upon this name. I came here expressly to take them back in chains to the chief priest. But Saul grew all the stronger and confused the Jews who live in Damascus, providing that is the Christ. Response to Psalm. Psalm 116:6. Response. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Praise the Lord, all your nation. Glorify him, all your peoples. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. For the steadfast is his kindness toward us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Alleluia. John 15, verse 16. I chose you from the world to go and bear fruit that will last, says the Lord. Gospel. Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel. A reading of the Holy Gospel according to Mark 16, verse 15 to 18. Jesus appeared to the 11 and said to them, Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. These signs will accompany those who believe. In my name they will drive out demons. They will speak new language. They will pick up serpents. Death with their hands. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick and they will recover. First reading. Dear brothers, St. Paul's conversion is a joy and a great blessing for the whole church. Personally, for me, it also means a great joy. St. Paul, his encounter with Jesus Christ awakened and converted many people. His conversion renewed the church, its mission. It was a great new strength received by the first Christian community. St. Paul found Jesus Christ and proclaimed him to the end of his existence. From his encounter with Jesus Christ since his conversion, the whole meaning of his life was Christ. The same he says it in Galatians 2, verse 19 to 20. It is not I who live, it is Christ who lives in me. What a joy to celebrate the conversion of St. Paul today. And to us, does that conversion encourage us? Because Jesus Christ is also looking for us. If we have not found you yet, we must know that you are looking for us, because he loves us. He seeks us, follows us, wants us to belong to him totally and perfectly. Jesus Christ is searching your heart. All Christian faith begins by an event of encounter with Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ is alive. He walks with us, he can touch us, he promises, and he doesn't lie. Because Jesus Christ is the truth itself and cannot lie. He is with us, and we don't know in which way we can find him. What is really true is that we always find him in the church. He is alive in the Eucharistic. He is alive in your word. He is alive in the sacraments. He's alive in his ministers. He's alive in all the people who serve us with true love, with pure love, with the sole interest of leading us towards eternal life. Jesus Christ is alive. Perhaps we find him abroad, as happened to St. Paul. Saint that meeting depth that he had with Christ rose to speak incessantly his conversion. Undoubtedly, his conversion must be the conversion of all the cultures, beginning Jewish culture, which believes by revelation but what is written, but he Christians tell Jews that Jesus Christ is alive. He is alive. There is a path, then, that they must travel from the culture of writing to living culture, which is Jesus Christ himself. Jesus Christ appears risen in a path to change St. Paul and convert him. This fact surpasses all that is was written. For this reason, the Church fully believes in the tradition and believes beyond what is written, because tradition, faith, is the daily life of the Church. Jesus Christ walks with us. He makes history in us and in the whole Church. The conversion of St. Paul must be the conversion of every Jew who meets to Jesus Christ. They might say, then that God, that I couldn't even pronounce his name, now do you ask me to proclaim him in Jesus Christ, his Son? Yes, it is so, because Jesus Christ is God. He said to the Jews, before Abraham was born, I am. John 8, verse 56 to 58. Jesus had no beginning and no end. He is eternal. He is the one who introduced us to his Father and the one who brings us his Holy Spirit. Every culture, beginning with the Jewish culture, must be baptized. Each culture he has his way of talking about God, but they are goods who have no faith. Or the living God has decided to come out of the clouds to incarnate in the Virgin Mary, to be touched, has even agreed to be humiliated to show us the way of salvation, to redeem us from our weaknesses. It is a God who is incarnate for love, who suffers for love, who is resurrected for love, and who is with us for love. Many people, including many Christians, are used to speaking of God and now. They have not yet made the road to Damascus. Really, which is the difference between them and Saul? Because St. Paul, before his conversion, he also spoke of God, of the God of Israel, of his parents, but it was the God that no one had sent yet. However, Christians see God by Jesus Christ. Many people are used to say God. The Greeks had their gods, the Egyptians too, and so do all the peoples. The moment of conversion of St. Paul helped all cultures to get out of these unknown divinities to contemplate the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to look at Jesus Christ, who is the face of the Father, the one who gives us his spirit of love, the one that truly converts our heart. And if we really find Jesus Christ, we will talk of him as did St. Paul. His conversion must also be ours, of the same way that our mission must be its same mission. He kept repeating that Jesus Christ crucified was his message, and he could not speak of another thing. And we, what do we preach? Sometimes intelligent, rational speeches, but it is about something simple. Introducing Jesus Christ to our brother. This is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. That was the preaching of St. John the Baptist, and that was what we have to do. Preach to Jesus Christ. Here is Jesus Christ, and we are with him. We have risen from the dead, it's alive. He can do whatever we want. He is our Lord, he is our King, he is our love. He is our life, he is our glory, Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ. Talking about Jesus Christ was the joy of all who had received the Spirit Holy on the day of Pentecostes. And since St. Paul was converted, talk about him was also his joy. What joy I had, because always when talking about he, Jesus Christ appears, converts, heals, acts, cast out demons. Have done to convert, change our language, and never again say God, just plain. Now from today we shall say Jesus Christ, or if we speak of the Father, should God Father, as Jesus taught us. God is the Father, Almighty God the Father, as the Church always says, and always if we speak to God, do it in the most holy name of Jesus Christ, without forgetting that the Father of Jesus Christ is pleased, may we in Christ call him Abba, Papa. Abba, Daddy, give us your Holy Spirit, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, so that we can talk about him, so that we can be his witnesses. Glory to you, Eternal Father, Abba, Father, Abba, Dad. It is the Spirit of Jesus Christ that is in us, continually confirming us that we are his children, calling him the same way that he did. Abba, Father. Blessed are those who ceaselessly proclaim Jesus Christ and those who act in her name. That was the life, the passion of St. Paul, and it must be ours. That shall be our joy, proclaiming Jesus Christ, talking about Jesus Christ, acting in his name, Jesus Christ. Glory to you, Lord Jesus. Come, Holy Spirit, Spirit of peace. Come, Spirit of Jesus Christ, come. Immaculate Heart of Mary, protect us. Talk second. Dear brothers, today your Lord Jesus Christ presents himself with great joy, showing us the work he did of Saul, an apostle, of the way to which he used to fight. Jesus Christ wants to celebrate this important event in the life of the whole church. Jesus Christ, by his Holy Spirit, convert St. Paul, convert the persecutor, and make him the apostle, the herald tireless of his mighty name. Jesus Christ appears before us so that by that great power that changed St. Paul, we too may be changed into apostles and true witnesses of that name, Jesus Christ. What power! Look how many enemies had Jesus Christ since he began to preach. And where are they? Where is it so? How many enemies Jesus Christ has had throughout all the centuries? But where are they? How many enemies Jesus Christ has now? And where will they go? They have heard of Jesus Christ. But what can surprise in his mercy that surprised St. Paul, when I was going to fight against him? Against witness itself, against mercy himself, against the light of the lights, against the glare of the lights, against the love of love. He was surprised, he was defeated, and he was converted. He was convinced and he was converted to that love that was violent, the one that did not have mercy, the one who was wicked, although he was a believer. That should teach us many things. A believer can also be full of violence and evil. Today, Christ wants to convert all believers. All those who pretend belief, but those whose heart is full of evil and violence. Sometimes they direct their violence against those who do not have the same belief as them, forgetting that they themselves are worse, because their belief is all in their mind, in their rituals, in his worship, but not in his heart. That blindness of the believers, the one that had St. Paul, is the one that Jesus Christ cured him, convert him from persecutor to apostle. Today, we all need that conversion of St. Paul, because in general, we have violence against those who do not believe like us. Just for that we comfort them victoriously or in a more belief way, but in general, to a different degree, we have that violence. That is why there have been wars of religions always, and continue today. We are all guilty, because every believer harbors violence, an attitude clear or hidden in their heart, which belittles or does not receive those who do not believe like me. But Jesus Christ is the light of all. He is the light for all. Shone in the darkness from the heart of St. Paul and convert him to the light. He who walked in darkness, he who was darkness, and he himself says, was turned into the light of the nations by the power of Jesus Christ. Today Jesus Christ visits all of us to become truly in light, in radiance, in the middle of this world full of violence, darkness, violence, hatred, evil. Jesus Christ wants to do of us light for all but one. St. Paul walked violently, full of evil, in the name of his belief. Jesus Christ convert him. Today, he wants to convert me, convert you, so that our faith in him be a light of mercy, goodness, meekness, and not of violence, because we ourselves, Catholic Christians, have the violence against those who are not Catholic or those who do not believe. Jesus Christ, what is living love, it wants to turn us into love. Jesus Christ, who is light, loves us to shine from within so that we can shine lovingly. So did St. Paul, light of the nations. May Jesus Christ make us messengers of light through the prayer of St. Paul, in messengers of love, because he sends us as witnesses of love, that love which is himself, that love that casts out demons and heals, relieving pain of the torn of hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Immaculate Heart of Mary, protect us. Our Lady of Carmen, pray for us. Jesus Christ, be praised.